Mountains ecosystems are among the world's most fragile. They're home to an extraordinary range of plants and animals. They are the source of the world's rivers. Mountains are home to 10% of the world's peoples. Unforgiving but majestic landscape of Gorno-Badakhshan, an autonomous region of Tajikistan in Central Asia. The land here is often above 7,000 meters high. Even the lowland valleys are 2,000 meters above sea level. This was the unlikely home of an ancient culture living in balance with meager natural resources. 70 years of Soviet rule brought complete dependency based on a heavy subsidy system and a loss of traditional survival skills. When the Soviet Union collapsed, so did Tajikistan. It was left with a crippled economy and an environment unable to support the population. A bloody civil war followed, bringing the country to ruin. Since the end of major hostilities in 1993, the region has been making a comeback. People are now thinking for themselves, building on much-needed stability. This is a close-knit society, proud of its cultural heritage, its tradition of hospitality, and its folklore. Indeed, today, Gorno-Badakhshan could be used as a model for building economic and civil stability in neighboring states, particularly Afghanistan, with whom it shares an extensive border. What has caused this turnaround, and could Afghanistan follow in its footsteps? This week, Earth Report visits these people of the sky. Tajikistan lies in the great mountain chains of Asia. It is north of Pakistan and bordered by China, Kyrgyzstan, and Uzbekistan, as well as its most notorious neighbor, Afghanistan, with whom it shares its longest border. Gorno-Badakhshan lies in eastern Tajikistan in the Pamir Mountains. Under the Russian Empire and the Soviets, the area was strategically important. In order to maintain population levels in this inhospitable region, the Soviets used the agricultural output of Russia and the Ukraine and massive industrialization to subsidize life in the Central Asian republics.
Why are these 210,000 people living in this place? I am telling you that in the Soviet time, the Soviet Union did its best to keep here as much as possible people, because it was strategically border with China, border with Afghanistan, Pakistan. The government motivated the mothers, motivated the population to stay here and to have much more people in Gorno-Badakhshan.
But life in Gorno-Badakhshan was all right.
We thought, and people older than me, they thought it is excellent life. Cannot be anything better than this in the world. Everything was on the show, people had some job. And we did know how it is coming, from where.
But under the surface, all was not well.
On that time, Gorno-Badakhshan provide food, for example, bread, just covered 15% its need from its local harvest. 80% bread, flour came from outside. 100% industry, 100% fuel, 100% machinery, everything came from that side. It was huge dependency. Sometimes the people jerking this and the Soviet Union taught to us how to eat fish, but it didn't teach to us how to catch the fish. And then all the system broken, it like you turn off the light.
Formal independence came in 1991, but with it a full realization of the extent of the dependency the population had on the centralized Soviet system. Worse was to follow. The power vacuum caused by the Soviet collapse triggered a bloody civil war. 50,000 people were killed throughout Tajikistan. Sadbag was a teacher during this time. Her family, like all families in Gorno-Badakhshan, suffered great hardship. Her father had no work and no money for food.
The civil war in my country, it was really very terrible, because during that war in my country, I can say that the brother killed his brother. People faced many, many problems like illness, like to be hungry.
In desperation, Sadbag's father sold all his possessions in order to buy food, which he shared with the village.
If I will eat bread, and my neighbor, he's my friend, he's looking at me, I can't enjoy myself at all. But if we all, both, we will eat it, it will be great. And it will be very, very tasty, even if it will be just simple water.
The civil war led to total collapse. Among the problems, an energy crisis. Without subsidized oil, the people of Gorno-Badakhshan turned to stripping the forest. Within a few years, 70% of the forests were cut down. Without forest cover, thin mountain soils are lost, and flooding and landslides increase.
The economy totally was broken. All the state factory, they all were broken. So many things were stolen. People didn't work, just fight. And now we are worse than the center of Asia.
The country was starving. With their resources spent, major hostilities ceased in 1993, and people looked for new solutions to their survival. One of the first development agencies to start work, beginning in 1992, was the Mountain Society's Development Support Program, a part of the Aga Khan Development Network. A crucial part of their strategy was to involve local people to help instigate reform. Sorban was an engineer before the Civil War. However, armed bands destabilized the country and threatened a fragile peace. Thousands had no jobs and no money. The Aga Khan Development Network is helping these men find work and gain new skills to help the region rebuild. In post-civil war Gorno-Badakhshan, if wages can be found, there's plenty of work to do.
They have lost a lot of their relatives, parents, family, jobs. They have totally lost their former lives. Their thinking had changed. We thought that we should find long-term projects for
them.
We wanted them to be busy for a long time, put down their guns and pick up a shovel. The point was to make them think about work, shovels and pickaxes, and not about guns.
Before the war, I had a nice job.
salary, an apartment. It happened all in one night. We woke up in the morning and there were strikes, meetings everywhere. It was a normal day for us. We woke up and went to work as usual. But by the end of the day, I found myself in the middle of the war. The most important thing is for the men to have work and not have time to think about the war. The war is finished and we have to think about our future.
At 3,000 meters, nestling below a mountain ridge, lies the village of Darjeon. It is too remote to expect power from the central energy grid. Yet today, the villagers are celebrating. Championing sustainable development, the Aga Khan Development Network has instigated a mini hydro power program, a source of clean, renewable energy much suited to mountain terrain.
We do not have enough electricity power. So people cut down the trees for fuel. Doing this, we destroy our environment. But people have no choice. When we have energy, nature will not suffer. We can make our country beautiful and develop tourism.
Mini hydro plants enable power to be generated close to villages. They don't need access to a national grid and provide local employment opportunities. Without resources, the government was unable to guarantee services to remote communities. But with the help of the Aga Khan Development Network, village organizations were able to take charge of their own affairs.
When the collective system disappeared in 1998, there was no organization for the villages. The villages remained without any leadership.
The aim of these village community organizations is to mobilize people, to unite them, to make their contributions, save money and use it for their benefit, so that the villagers themselves become the leaders, the managers of their land, their money and their produce.
These programs have raised the status of women within our community.
همه این زنای علمی علی داشتن همه بیکار یگون کس کار نکرد لیکن من طاقت نکردم که کار نکنم من رفتم به زمان تشکیلات گذشته که کمپانی برهم کرده من رفتم تشکیلات بودم جمعیت مطلوبات همونجا کار کردم
From the beginning the women wanted to be involved It was the men who didn't want them there زنان
بسیار خواستن نکه مردم که نمیخواستن
Village committees gave Marjan a forum from where she could organize community businesses for women. At first, they worked at home making pastries or clothes which were sold in the local market. The men wouldn't let the women go to sell them, sending their children instead. But when the men realized how much money could be made, they changed their tune.
بعد ما وایو خطی رفتیم خونه امون مردک رفتیم وایو میپرسیم که امون زن میپرسد این نفر که چقدر در اومد کردیم وایو گفت 100 سومونی برابر این معاش من ما خود من با نکان خیلی گو کردم که 100 سومونی بعد روز وقت شفاش کوچه و دیدم
گفتم راه میخورد چه خیلی گفتی
ست تشکر با تا
وی تشکر با تا که تو
در حیات این یک پیرورود به آورد لحمش سنبوسه تیار میکنن وی از تخونش آب با میپزن سهری دسترخون با میورد
وای مردک روز بر روز اینجا راست شدستن
وای میگه این نتیجه کاری تو من اکه ساری گوشت میخرم
و این یک چیزی شد در حیات زنان در حیات زنان وقتی که اولین بار وای بزرگ برامدن
مردم وای وای خیلی خیلی نگو میکردن
این یک چیزی دهشت
اینجا زنی در روزی بزرگ و ایستاده مردم با فروخته استن
An important part of community life is religion. Much has been made of the extremist and fundamentalist aspects of religion in this part of the world, particularly in relation to women. In fact, what we find in Gorno-Badakhshan is a tolerant, open-minded approach to the Quran and the teachings of Muhammad.
میگو اگر خدا خوا حضرت محمد میگه دین من درخت است یعنی یک درخت شو خود زیاد داره
یعنی دین ها
من خیلی زیادن
It is one tree, but it has many branches. It is the same with the religion. There are many branches in our religion. We have people of different countries with different languages and traditions, but all follow Islam. And the teachings of Muhammad, his life was an example for all of us.
Music and dance form a central place in the lives of the people. They are used to welcome guests, celebrate marriages, for feast days or any other time. Everyone joins in, including the local school's headmaster.
مهمون نوازی این از گفته خدا و رسول و پیامبر خدای تعالی از روز یعنی که آدم خلق کرد خواست که روح در آدم برد ندرماد بنابرای نغمه درست
کرد او نغمه قطی
روح
با آدم درماد بنابرای
آدم نغمه را خرسندی را دوست می دارد حضرت شمس من این کتاب شمس
در این میگه که چوبه بی تراشی دوان بسته
دسیتار قومه خورم صد ناله زار از دیری هر تار برامد تار او نماشد یعنی از روز اول که آدم خدا خلق کرد تا نغمه قطی مست نکر روه در آدم ندرمد یعنی بنابرای آدم همی خرسندی و نغمه را از اولین شده توش می دارد این هم تا
The holy family and our peers all agreed that music has followed man from the beginning.
When the Khalifa was 18, he fell in love with a young girl. But fate was not in their favor, and they both married other people. After 50 years, his wife died, and so did her husband. They asked their children whether it would be all right for them to marry. Each of them had five children. They said that after a period of mourning, they
cried.
Our children agreed, and we have a good life now. We love each other. Now everything is fine.
The beauty of the music and culture is often matched by the landscape. But making a living is not easy. Farming in a territory which is 93% covered by mountains carries its dangers. The village of Dasht in the Roshtkala district was very beautiful. A traditional village clinging to the valley with a small river running through it. But during the hot summer months, the frozen snow high above melted. And just a week before our film crew arrived, there was a catastrophic avalanche.
The residents of the area come each other, each day at night. Yes, then, Masham, представим сконечуде.
It happened suddenly in the night. Nobody expected it. We could not imagine that our land could be so harsh with us. The main cause was the ice caps. When it's very hot, it begins to melt and drops down like an avalanche. We live in the valley at about 2,500 meters. So from this height, this mass comes down at phenomenal speeds. There are boulders in there, mud, everything coming down onto the village.
As soon as I saw the land
Dr. Paikamo organizes what help she can for the villagers with the limited resources at her disposal.
The doctors face many problems. Because 573 people have no medical point over there.
The flood washed away 7 kilometers of road. There is a huge lake there now. We have to build the road now during August and September because the winter is coming.
75% of the villages of Gorno-Badakhshan are at risk from avalanche. It's a serious problem which deforestation does nothing to help. Schools are a certain way to help disseminate information on environmental management, health and other issues. And it's here that the positive legacy of the Soviet Union should not be underestimated. Part of the reason Gorno-Badakhshan is recovering so quickly is that it has a 97% literacy rate, unlike neighboring Afghanistan, where the rate is as low as 5%. Today, it's the lack of electricity that hinders learning.
It is extremely cold in classes in winter. It's approximately minus 5 degrees centigrade. It is so cold that the students cannot even write because their hands are numb with the cold.
On top of this, the salary of teachers has dropped so dramatically that many have left the profession or work part-time so they can farm land for food. The children, too, are often tired from helping out between classes with the family farming. Farming was not able to support the population. The old-style communist collectives were inefficient.
I was a teacher during the collective farm period, but I also farmed the land. In those days, there was very little knowledge of how to get the best from the land. In the days of the collective farm, so many people would sit in the offices. They were the apparatchiks, and there were just a few people working in the fields. Of course, the problem was that none of the office people wanted to lose their jobs. So they tried to hold back any reform of farming missions.
However, regardless of what the apparatchiks wanted, without the Soviet subsidies, the collective farms collapsed. Without money, the new government embarked on a political solution, land privatization.
Government today don't have money to give to the farmers seed or fertilize or do agriculture extension. But first, they help us politically. They give land to the people, the government of Oblast approved it, 100% land now is private.
Development agencies supplemented the privatization program by introducing modern farming methods. Good quality seed and crop rotation made better use of the soil. Food self-sufficiency is now within reach.
I would like to give one example. I remember during the collective farm period in this village, we had 7 hectares of land and the wheat, and the total harvest was about 7 tons. In other words, just 1 ton per hectare. Now I get 7 tons per hectare, which means my 1 hectare of land produces the same as 7 hectares did under the old system.
Across this river, there are farmers on the other side with the same soil, the same problems, they are the same race, often of the same family, but they have none of the solutions. These are Afghani farmers. With help from the Aga Khan Development Network, the people of Gorno-Badakhshan are building a bridge to them. But how far will the development successes of one region translate to the other? What does seem certain is that these two peoples, divided by an arbitrary political boundary drawn by the Soviets 70 years ago, share a common future.
Afghanistan is part of our life. We can't change this. If there is an epidemic of typhoid there, we get it here a day later. Or any animal diseases, they just come over. There's only a river separating us, but they are not strangers, you know. They are our relatives. Their illness is our illness. Their problems, our problems. Their happiness, our happiness. I think our success will be their success, and theirs ours.
Finding jobs for former combatants, building renewable energy mini-hydro systems, helping reconstruct civil society through community groups, and food self-sufficiency through land reform, education, these are the development goals of today. But at best, they can only be a beginning. The fruit of today's labor lies in the hands of the children of Gorno-Badakhshan.
I want to see our future. Peace. First of all, peace for the children.
I want my children to be part of a Muslim country, part of the international community.
We work like camels and live like horses. But our children will work like horses and live like human beings. I hope our grandchildren will work like human beings but live like kings.
I am telling you that in the Soviet time, the Soviet Union did its best to keep here as much as possible people.
During that war in my country, I can say that the brother killed his brother.
از اون جمله وقت دمسیل لند 24 نفر الوکسد افتودنو خوجه که بی ایچ چیزت من نرید فقط خوجه ندیند چی رو چود از دمسیل
چی بگم تا تقریبا اگر گویم مثل نرم اساسی هم مقدار اساسی تیمپراتور سینخانه باید تا 20 درجه باشد 20 گرادوس باشد یکیز میستم
بورزان بوده ده ایدسیانه ایدا سفخوز مردمین آرتین زمان نادیم با مقابله ایدوانه ده گروه کم خوشگی ده خونه تماماً بر
هر چیز درد یفنسا یکو درد ماشا میسیست هر چیز یفنت خوشیسا که خوش ماشا است ماشا سپیخ تا گمیم یفنسید بیر سپیخ ماشا یک کنو آیی ماشا سر این مسید پرابلیم این نیمیر یک ماشا